Hello, FIT. Today is a very special day as Chancellor Nancy Zimper is making her third stop at FIT to have a strategic plan and forum to talk about innovation and technology on campus. Not only that, but we will also be talking about arts and culture and spreading that awareness on campus. Be a part of SUNY's future. Be a part of FIT's future. Be a part of your future. This is Philip Salem for WFIT. Come check it out.
More than 200 members of the community of 64 statewide SUNY schools have gathered together on the FIT campus to engage in an open forum and dialogue to discuss how innovation, arts, and culture can come together. This is also a groundbreaking day for WFIT as it is the first time we will be streaming our broadcast live via webcast. I'll be joined by my fellow SUNY News correspondent Philip Salem, and we'll be bringing our FIT students all that and more.
Student delegate for the strategic process planning group, and what I do is I represent the students and I let them know what we can do for the students in terms of the SUNY organization altogether.
And then also how innovation and technology is encompassed with that, correct? What type of subtopics are we going to be discussing within arts and culture?
Overall, just building it into the curriculum, how we can keep it a strong academic area of academics at SUNY as well as at FIT. Mm-hmm.
Can you tell me what's going to go on today?
Well, today is going to be a great conversation where we're going to be discussing the future of SUNY. People from all of the 64 campuses are going to be here.
What do you think makes FIT so unique from all 64 campuses?
Well, I think being in the heart of Manhattan really makes us unique. And I think that the vitality of the students, the faculty, the programs we offer are really very special. We have programs that are nowhere else in the United States, let alone the state of New York. And I think that that really sets us apart.
Most of the majors here are business related.
Right.
People tend to forget that because we are the Fashion Institute of Technology. But how are we going to incorporate arts and cultures in business?
Well, I think that as art, and I think that art has proliferated into the world, and fashion is now really considered an art form when at one point it wasn't. So I think that we're seeing a big change in the way art is being viewed by the general public.
The point of the conversations is to bring up topics that Chancellor Zimper thinks are going to be important to establishing her strategic planning. So it's not, like you said, it's not tailored to each school. It's things that the entire SUNY system should be doing. So in terms of arts and culture, I mean, obviously we're in an appropriate place to be talking about arts and culture. But there's, you know, New York State art, it's a very big part of New York State history, and it happens all across the state, and there are artists all across the state and all across all the different SUNY schools. A lot of them have arts programs. They churn out great artists. And even if they, you know, another big thing that we're going to be talking about today is you don't have to be an art major to be interested in art. It's a part of being a part of society. It's a part of your general education that you should be getting at SUNY schools. So that's another big part.
So what topics do you specifically want to talk about today?
Well, today the major focus is on arts and the community, so we'll be talking about a topic that ought to be very familiar to FIT,
definitely,
right?
Definitely, but it's also familiar with throughout different schools, and you are for community colleges, correct?
Yes.
So what types of arts and cultures do they bring to the table?
Well, if we start with FIT, they bring everything to the table in terms of the arts, but in every community, the community college is a center for the arts and kind of a cultural focus area, because they will not only have programs in the arts, visual arts, performing arts, they also bring in artists and performers to the community. And if you go to some of our upstate communities in the rural areas, the community colleges are one of the chief focal points for community activities, including cultural events. We just have to make sure that the campuses are structured in a way that they're aware of the necessity of reflecting the community they serve and take positive active steps to reflect that.
We are particularly pleased about the SUNY strategic plan endeavor because we ourselves are in the midst of implementing our own strategic plan. And like the SUNY plan, it is long term. It reaches out to 2020, or as we often say, 2020 and beyond, because it changes and moves out every day as we watch. And although it was launched in 2004, 5 years ago, it remains a living, breathing document. It's a work in progress, and it's one really that guides us systematically.
I'm becoming a regular at FIT. I have done the American Beauty Museum exhibit. I brought friends and relatives. I intend to continue to do that. It's a wonderful experience, the faculty exhibit, just the energy of being at FIT.
In my remarks, I talked about FIT being an exemplar, not only for the State University, but for New York and the country. I mean, you, I think, exemplify better than any other educational institution in the state the power, transformative power, of art and culture. But I think what you see here, particularly at the Fashion Institute, is the impulse to convert artistic expression into economic activity. And you and your colleagues do that surpassingly well. If we can figure out how to do a good deal more of that across the entire SUNY system, I think we'll have done a very good thing.
Well, I think that the issue of art and sustainability is very important. So on the one hand, I think artists have been important thinkers about these issues, about materials and use. And I do think people in their own practices across the various fields of the arts are looking at how they can be more green, how they can be more sustainable. But more importantly, however, I think that for sustainability to become a real issue that we all adopt in our lives, the creative thinking needed to kind of shift us into a place where we understand the limited amount of resources on this planet for all the people, I think artists and visual and creative producers are going to be critical to moving that dialogue forward.
This is a part of a big idea that the State University of New York can really be a critical player in the economic revitalization of the state of New York and its enhanced quality of life. So actually, talking about arts and culture feeds both of those ideas. The revenues generated by the arts and by cultural experiences, from museums to performing arts to art shows on the streets to storefronts, and the coffee shops and restaurants and living areas that grow up around them, brings revenue to the state of New York. And already New York City knows this. We just need to spread the idea. And then secondly, we should be about enhancing the quality of life of the citizenry of New York. It's not all about revenue. It's about the lived experience of the arts. And so we had a wonderful speaker today, Thelma Golden.
So phenomenal.
And she was right on task. It was perfect. She asked us to think about creative ideas that the whole system could engage in. It's really impressive.
You know, again, I think it is about thinking about the arts as something that's not the side or a frill. I mean, I often meet students, talk to students I teach, and I am so encouraging of students to take an art course.
We in higher education can also promote artists in residence on our campuses. We can promote easy access of our students to go to museums, to go to performing arts. And, you know, someone even recommended that all this should be free to students, which
we definitely like free.
Everybody agrees to that in principle. How can we make that happen? But that is the whole point of this discussion. What are the strategic, tangible, concrete ideas that we can generate and execute as a whole system across 64 campuses that will bring the arts and culture to all of our students and to our communities?